Och långa passning upp för Otto Weidman som sätter bollen efter 3:51 bortaledning.
Hi everyone, back again with another video. I'd just like to have a look at this goal here that was scored by Jönköping in a recent match against Fagerhult. So just to set the scene, the ball is with this player here. Jönköping is the white team and they are heading this way. So I'll just move it through a little bit further so I can start the analysis. Okay, so from here you can see that the pass has been made from one white defenseman to the other white defenseman across here. So I'll just go through a couple of things here. So the first one is that the white players, the two white players at the back, are quite wide. If we take it back a little bit to here, you'll see that this player who receives the ball is actually much closer to the middle of the court. And as the pass is made, he backs up and backs up and backs up and gives width to the structure of his team. And what that does is it actually creates space through the middle area of the court here. And it separates these two red players because they're sort of heading towards the respective defensemen. And that space in this scenario is what allows the pass to be made. You probably saw in the clip that the pass ends up going through that gap to this player who's just started to move, you can see here. It's the width there that creates the space for the pass to get through. So that's the first point. The next point is that the white team do have quite a bit of depth. They are quite deep in their own zone. If you have a look at where this player is receiving the ball, it's about the top of the box here. And what that does, as I've explained in a previous video, is that creates space vertically along the court, so lengthways here. And it is that space created along the court vertically which gives the recipient of the ball room to receive the ball and time to make a decision because there's plenty of space there. Had these players at the back been further up, let's say somewhere around this line here, then everyone else would be shifted up as well. And there'd be much less space in this middle area and much less space vertically for this player here to receive the ball and have time to make a decision without being under pressure because they'd be further up the court and there'd probably be a defensive player closer to them, so they wouldn't have the time to make that decision that they ended up making. So I thought that this scenario here illustrated those two principles beautifully. So the width pulled these two red players apart and allowed the pass to be made through the middle, and the depth allowed this white player to receive the ball without pressure and make a decision from there. The next thing to note is that the red team are severely outnumbered here. They've basically sent two forwards in against four white players here. So just based on the numbers, the white team are probably going to be able to advance the ball out of their zone somehow because it's essentially a 4-on-2 situation. I'm not exactly sure what the red team was thinking here, but the white team have a really nice outnumbering situation, so I thought that was worth pointing out as well. Okay, so the next thing I'd like to talk about is the individual skill and decision making displayed by this player here. So the first thing is that he recognizes that space is being created by these two red players moving forward or advancing down the court into the white team's zone. And as soon as he realizes that, he starts to exploit the space. He also probably realizes that there is a passing lane between them because of the width of the two white players at the back here. And that's what prompts him to lead into that space. So I'll just move it through a little bit here so you can see that. So he's recognized it now and he started to move. So that's the first thing. It's a really good recognition of where the space is about to be available and getting in there to exploit it, as well as the passing lanes that are available. So the next thing is just his awareness of how the situation is evolving as he moves into that space. So I've zoomed it in a little bit here. So let's just watch as it goes through. If we move it back, initially here, he's looking at the player with the ball on the opposite side of the court. And as he moves in, he starts to have a look into the space. Now just watch his head here. I know it's a little bit blurry because of the quality, but as he comes in, see that head check there? He just has a look in here to see what's happening in the space. And you can see from here, the field of vision is probably around here. So he's having a look to see if there's any pressure coming in from this way, any red players. And as we move it through, he turns and has a look at the ball carrier again, and he sets up to receive. And as the ball comes, he does a head check first. And now he's having a look to see what is happening so that he can make a decision when he gets the ball. So if we zoom it out from there, we'll take it out a little bit. You can see that now he can see this red player here. He can see this player here, and he's evaluating his options before the ball even gets to him. And that leads to the next point, which is this player that receives the ball actually uses some very subtle deception to misdirect this player here. So what you'll see is that if we take it back a frame, if you looked at this frame here, you can see that this player is about to receive the ball, and given the body position and the way that he is facing, you would think that the ball is probably going to come to this player here with a one-touch pass. It could potentially go down to this player that's coming on. It's definitely not going back to this player who just passed it, but it's more than likely going to come to this player closest to us. And that is actually what this red player who you can see coming up here thinks. So if we take it forward a little bit here, from here, you would still think that the ball is going to this number 77, the white player that's closest to us. And that is what the red player thinks. And the red player is essentially coming up to try and either cut this pass or to be in a position to pressure this player directly once they receive the ball. But what happens is the white player receiving the ball decides that he's not going to make that pass. And as a result, if we take it back, you can see the red player actually does a stutter step here because they realize they're going to have to change their course of action. And rather than coming to this player out here, they're going to have to start to head this way because the white player has taken the ball and run with it. So you can see that little stutter step there. It's a little bit more evident when it's played at full speed. So I'll play it at full speed so you can see it. So taking it back, the deception shown by this player is really good and it's very subtle. Now, whether it's actually intentional deception or whether it's just situational awareness and flexibility, maybe he didn't intend to deceive this player here, but maybe because of his awareness of what was happening, he read that this player coming up here was probably going to put his primary passing option under immediate pressure. He just decided, well, look, that's not a good option anymore, but you know what? I've got another option. I can just take the ball myself because if this player is heading this way, it's created space for me over here to run into. So really nice move there, very subtle, but I just wanted to point that out. And the last bit of skill and decision-making that I'd like to highlight from this white player here is the way that they receive the ball. So pretty much once they've made their decision that they're going to take the ball themselves and run with it, they just let the ball run. So even when we have a look here, if you think this player is going to receive it, you think they might have to step a little bit this way because of the way they're facing. But they've recognized that they are in a good position where they are. All they have to do is turn their body. The ball is on a good trajectory. It's heading this way. If they had taken these steps closer to meet the ball, then their momentum would have carried them into this area here, and they would have ended up in trouble because they would be too close to this player here and they'd be under pressure. So what the player decided to do was just allow the ball to run and then basically just turn their body and reposition their footing so that they could go with the ball. And they used the ball's speed to their advantage. The ball had plenty of speed on it. All they did was turn and match the speed of the ball, and that carried them into the attack without any problem. So I'll just take that through slowly here. So there's just a repositioning of the feet, and he doesn't even take a touch until the ball is well out in front of him here. So that's really nice. And from there, you can see he's already repositioned his feet and he started moving that direction. The next one or two steps are going to be very powerful steps to get up to speed with the ball and accelerate into that space. And then basically it's just him taking it to the net and figuring out what to do from there. And that turning with the ball and knowing that the space was there allows him to get his head up, which you can see here, and he's already evaluating options, which allows him to see where the goalie is and end up making a good shot. So that is all I really have to say on the attacking side of things. I just wanted to highlight those few things there, the width, the depth, the outnumbering situation, and the incredible awareness, decision-making, and skill shown by this player here in a matter of seconds. I'm not going to analyze the defense in this video, mainly because it's fairly obvious what has happened, and most of it is just the opposite side of the points I have gone over in attack. That being said, I would like to know what you think about the defense set up by the red team here. What system were they playing? Why did they allow an outnumbering situation against their two forwards? Perhaps they were caught changing players at a bad time. I'm not sure, but I'd like to know what you think. So thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.
Åker blå med passning för Otto Weidman som sätter bollen efter 3.51 bortaledning.